Welcome to the 11th and final video in the Copilot for Security Flight School series. I'm Ryan Munch, your flight instructor. If you're watching this video, we're going to assume that you've watched all the prior lessons and have an instance of Copilot for Security ready to go. If you don't have Copilot ready, head over to MS Learn to begin your flight checks. As with prior videos, we'll be spending most of our time in the platform walking through how to become an ace at Copilot for Security. In this lesson, we'll spend our time focused on extending Copilot for your ecosystem. We have a lot to cover, so let's get airborne. Copilot's plugin architecture allows different types of plugins, and we'll address three: API, GPT, and KQL plugins. Each type has inherent advantages, and what's best suited for you depends on the workflow you intend Copilot to support. Most security workflows today are connected through an API, and this is likely the plugin type you'll use to connect your systems. API plugins in Copilot support custom endpoint URLs, multiple authentication types, and parameter passing to endpoints. This plugin type is best suited for external or non-Microsoft systems. The next variant, Custo Query Language, is great for querying and analyzing data at scale. If you've worked much at all with Microsoft products, there's a good chance your organization has a library of useful queries that you have developed over time. Those queries also make excellent skills, which is precisely what KQL plugins help facilitate. Finally, GPT plugins are a bit unique, and for many, a brand new concept. They don't connect to external systems, but instead provide an understanding to the underlying GPTs. Skills composed under GPT plugins are great at processing documents, unstructured data sets, and data analysis to provide new definitions for Copilot to use. Consider this. As any good security practitioner, you like to protect any reader from accidentally clicking on any type of malicious indicators. You do this manually today through a process known as defanging, which takes IPs and URLs and renders them inert. Through a GPT plugin, you can introduce the definition for how your organization likes to defang URLs to Copilot. This way, anytime you ask Copilot to defang an IP or URL, it knows precisely the way to format the indicator for you. Having calibrated our airspeed on the plugin options for Copilot, let's take a look at the custom API plugin I'd like to build for Copilot. My organization works with multiple threat intelligence sources, so I need to add capability for Alien Vault to support our normal due diligence workflows. We interact with Alien Vault through its API, which I'll connect with a custom plugin. API plugins come in two parts. One is the plugin schema, which can either work with OpenAI's plugin manifest or Copilot's specification. We'll use Copilot since it has a bit more capability. The schema will define the way to connect to the API, whether it requires authentication, and if so, the authentication type. It also provides a link to the settings file, which defines the API interactions. In the settings file, I provide a definition for the title and description, and declare individual skills in the same way. This helps Copilot with selection for prompt response. Skills can be aligned against different parts of the API, providing flexibility to send specific values and assemble the results uniquely back to the user. Let's now work with our custom plugin. I've already uploaded it, so I'm going to quickly enable it to make it available for Copilot's use in my session. With the plugin ready, I'll confirm the skills I created are now available as suggested prompts, which I'll check in my prompt bar. I'll start with the prompt. What details does Alien Vault know about 107.189.31.172? The results give me a good readout of the available threat intelligence. I'll use another skill to expand against malware associated with the IP. To round out this example, I'll take one last step by using a third skill to return information against the first malware hash. If I wanted to, I could now augment any of this information with other sources in Copilot to complete my workflow. I could also incorporate the plugin into custom prompt books or, as we just learned, logic apps. Knowledge bases are another type of source available for the orchestrator to leverage. Knowledge bases, or KBs, could include your company policies, incident response procedures, standard playbooks for handling phishing alerts, or report templates for communications across departments. This one is exciting because it means Copilot can leverage these resources within session context, giving you personalized support and further integration into your most critical workflows. For knowledge bases, there are two ways to bring in your organization's knowledge into Copilot: through file upload and through Azure AI Search. Let's briefly discuss using Azure AI Search by hopping into a demo. It's another day in Woodgrove, and unsurprisingly, we have another security incident. I slipped up and clicked on an email in support of a questionable business venture. I know, but investments in foreign royalty are too tempting. Alas, now it's time to investigate. Our response process starts by pasting in the email headers in question for analysis. In under a minute, I've got back a breakdown of the email. Using the response, I quickly learn about the origin and nature of the email. I can use that to uncover more about the email sender and their domain. Microsoft Defender Threat Intelligence can help me with exactly that. The passive DNS telemetry gives me a key piece of context that the domain resolving to the original email was only associated for a brief time. This is already suspicious. Next, I'll see what Copilot can provide for the IP and the domain. Sure enough, it's tied to a threat actor, Ruby Sleep. I could confirm the source data in MDTI, but I already have enough to understand the phishing threat they present. So I'll turn my attention to the takedown process by determining the registrant behind the registration for the suspicious domain. I can uncover that by asking about the registrar behind the domain. Next, I'll ask for a contact for the registrant so I know where to send my takedown notice. Typically, to incorporate my company's takedown template, I need to find the proper template and insert values from my investigation before sending. At Woodgrove, we use Azure AI Search to index and query our corporate content, like our policies and incident response templates. While not difficult, this certainly is time-consuming to do on my own. To expedite, I'll use Copilot to search with Azure AI Search to locate my template. This will look across my organization's Azure AI Search index for the information relevant to my prompt. Once located, the matching document helps compose my email while Copilot inserts the key values needed for the takedown process. In just a few seconds, Copilot has provided a finished email, which I can now export and send. As mentioned, KBs can cover your company policies, standard playbooks, or in this case, a communication template used for takedown requests. By incorporating these resources, Copilot gives you personalized assistance aligned with your unique processes and procedures. But if you're thinking, "Now, hit the air brakes, pilot, I don't use Azure AI Search," worry not. KBs can also be uploaded as files in their existing formatting. For file uploads, it works similar to Azure AI Search, only instead of an index, individual uploads are scoped either to the tenant or to the user, meaning the owner can determine if users can upload their own files or not. Should they grant that permission, users can then upload individual files for their use. Currently, only file types of docs, PDF, text, and .md are supported. I'll quickly show an example of what this looks like. When uploading files, there are limitations on the size, total capacity for each user, and the number of concurrent files that can be uploaded. CMS Learn for those exact details. After upload, the file is now available for Copilot to use, but note that unlike other sources like plugins, the orchestrator will not proactively reason over files as context for skill evaluations and responses. Instead, when wanting to use a file in a response, you'll need to mention uploaded files or the file name for Copilot to incorporate it into the prompt response context. KBs are helpful in instances where you might want to ask Copilot if the device in an incident is compliant with your corporate policy. Copilot can directly reference those documents, which grounds the results against your organization's standards. What's great about the KB capability is its seamless integration. You won't need to modify the document. It effortlessly handles unstructured text and requires no preparation or data normalization. My challenge to you is to now consider what teams, roles, or functions might have documents useful to your workflows. Or, similarly, those that own the documents, could they leverage the workflow necessitating the document on their own? Could you build that for them with a custom prompt book or custom plugin? With generative AI, the hope is that organizational specific processes are now more approachable. Let's take a moment to reflect on what we've just established with sources. The first type of source, plugins, allows you to use what is available out of the platform by default, or as we just learned, custom plugins provide extensibility so that you can cover more workflows across your organization. The other type of source, KBs, allow you to incorporate organizational specific information as context into workflows. Both are critical for facilitating the customization necessary to align Copilot to your organizational uses and are so important for getting the most from Copilot. And with that, you are now flight ready, pilots. Over the course of this series, we've learned about the fundamentals of AI, how Copilot's compound AI system and the orchestrator help enable the operator to be more successful with security in any context, no matter their discipline. With that foundation, you learned how to prompt effectively, turn those great flight plans into workflows for use in prompt books, and finally, extended Copilot in a way most useful for your organization or your specific needs. What an incredible long-haul flight it has been. I'm excited to see what you accomplish with Copilot in your organization. I'm Ryan Munch. I've had a blast taking you through flight school. I'll catch you next time, pilots.